Hunter, so what
Alejandro Jaregui raises bees.
I got that one over there.
And daily, he lifts over 80 hives to check them. When full of honey, they weigh over 70 pounds.
So I was having a lot of back issues.
And this lifting is more difficult for him because he has two artificial legs. While in the Army, he stepped on an IED landmine while clearing an area in Afghanistan in 2012.
Initially, one of my legs was completely gone. The other one was still attached, but it was just, you know, skin and stuff.
And now he does the physical job of raising bees with his two prosthetic legs.
It's about 70 pounds.
A veteran support group told him he might get some help with his physical job from students at Cal Poly San Luis Obispo.
And he told me about this college program where they had mechanical engineers and essentially said, hey, is there anything that you can think of? Maybe we can come up with a project to help you out and help them out, you know, with the school project.
And a four-man team of mechanical engineering students took on, as a class project, a way to lift beehives with a lot less exertion. They recently delivered their project to the bee farm. They call it the Beekeeper Assist.
I've spent a lot of mornings, early in the morning, in the shop on this thing. We all have. Yeah. This thing was a labor of love.
For Alejandro, the new tool means up to 80% less exertion.
All that hard work, long hours, finally seeing it work, pays off.
It works! It works!
The Beekeeper Assist works exactly as hoped for.
All the design process. Cal Poly learned by doing.
A new tool for a wounded warrior that will help him with his everyday task that can take its toll.
So there's days that I'm in more pain and there's days that I'm fine.
Yeah.
Days where I'm working hard and I'm down for 3 days. And so this will definitely make a difference on those days that I'm in pain.
Proud of what we did, and we're glad it worked as designed.
In Woodland, Will Hereford, KCRA 3 News.
What a cool thing that they did. Those students all graduated a week ago from Cal Poly, and their project received an A.